Hello guys, Brickheadz, and today we have over 50 brand new LEGO set images, so stay tuned and find out more. If you do enjoy the video, why not subscribe as well as turn notifications and like the video, but let's get into it. So first off, we actually start off with Monkie Kid, which has some real highlights this summer. So we have 80038, the Monkie Kid's team van. This one coming in at 1,406 pieces. It should be retailing for $130 and includes 6 minifigures. You can see that it's a massive vehicle, but you can also disassemble it all in a modular fashion and also open it up, which is really good. So it has that modular fashion to it, but also a pretty good vehicle. But now we move on to the absolute highlight of the summer wave for me. That's why I put this at the start of the video. 80039, the Heavenly Realms, with 2,433 pieces. This one being a giant temple build, which is, you can open up, has some incredible minifigures with some great designs. This one, just an amazing temple, is going to be coming in for $180 and launching on June 1st. You can see by the artwork just how good this one is, and one that I will definitely be picking up this summer. And then move on to what is like on Ninjago for summer 2022, the endgame season is being called. So we have 71768 Jay's Golden Dragon motorbike with 137 pieces, and it's going to include 2 minifigures and it's going to be retailing for $20. And then we have 71769 the Coast Dragon Cruiser with 384 pieces. That one includes 4 minifigures and should be retailing for $45. And then we have 71770 Jay's Golden Dragon Jet with 258 pieces, including 3 minifigures for $30. That one we've seen for quite a while now. And then we have 71771 at the Crystal King Temple with 703 pieces, including 6 minifigures. That one retailing for $80. And then we have the 71772 the Crystal King with 723 pieces with 5 minifigures for $70. Some of the minifigures in these sets are just incredible. And then we have 71773 Kai's Golden Dragon Raider with 624 pieces and 7 minifigures. That one coming in at $90. And then we get into some of the really big sets. We have 71774 Lloyd's Golden Ultra Dragon with 989 pieces. That one includes 9 minifigures, coming in at $140 due to a lot of big pieces, I presume. And then we have 71775 Nia Samurai X Mech with 1003 pieces, 8 minifigures, coming in at $120. That one, a great color scheme, incredible minifigures once again. And we also have 4 plus set being the Ninja Dragon Temple, coming in at $40. So pretty impressive with Ninjago wave compared to what we had in the start of the year. And then we move on to the brand new LEGO City set. So we have the brand new passenger train being 60337 in a green color scheme with 764 pieces, including 6 minifigures. That one coming in at $180. And then to go alongside that, a really good set is 60335 the train station with 907 pieces, coming in at $100, which seems pretty generous value given it has road plates and also a train track. And then we have an absolute highlight being 60347 the supermarket with 404 pieces, and it looks great, but included are 5 minifigures, which include a brand new amputee minifigure and also the pea suit girl returning. That one is going to be $70. And then we move on to LEGO City Stunts is once again continuing with a brand new wave. So we have 3 new stunt bikes with exclusive minifigures. They will be the usual $8 or £7. It includes some great minifigure designs, especially that guy in the bath. I'm sure that one will be very popular. And then we have 60313 the Space Ride Amusement Truck with 433 pieces. This one has an unknown price due to being a retailer exclusive. And then 60338, the Smashing Chimpanzee Stunt Loop with 226 pieces at 3 minifigures for $70. And then we have an absolutely crazily expensive set, 60339, the Double Loot Stunt Arena with 598 pieces and 7 minifigures, with a price at $150 due to just being massive track pieces. And then you have 60340, this one being the Blade Stunt Challenge, 154 pieces for $35. And 60341, the Knockdown Stunt Challenge with 117 pieces for $35. 60342, the Sharker Stack Chunt Challenge. Some of these are really hard to say, with so many words in them about the stunts attacking, with 122 pieces, 3 minifigures for $35. And then we have a brand new concept for LEGO City with 3 new mission sets for $40 or £35. These are going to work with some sort of app, and you can see in the wildlife one, it includes some brand new animal molds and also recolors, which are really nice. I could probably imagine these flopping as they don't seem too appealing, but it encourages free play and building. Nonetheless, if you add on the farm sets and also this farm polybag, which we got, and you add the farm sets, like I say, which got revealed last week, it concludes the LEGO City Summer 2022 wave, which is a lot better than I originally anticipated. We also have this miscellaneous LEGO minifigure pack, which should be launching as a LEGO store exclusive and includes some new minifigure designs and also that scooter piece, which has previously only been in LEGO Friends. That one is a really cheap set, coming in at £13, I think it is. And then we have some classic sets. So we have 11020, this one being a miscellaneous box of bricks, coming in at $100. And then we also have 11022, this one being a space classic set. Nothing exclusive or any anniversary set tied around this one like previously thought, unfortunately. We don't have a price on that one yet. And then one of the big surprises is 31206, the Rolling Stones mosaic, with 1,998 pieces, $150. We only have this image at the moment, but you can see it's totally different than the other art sets. You hang it on the wall, but it's actually just a busy build the massive lip design, rather than being in that framework with your typical LEGO art set. And then we move on to the brand new LEGO Mickey Mouse and Friends sets, these ones all being 4+. So we have 10777 Mickey and Minnie's Camping Trip with 103 pieces, with two variants of Mickey and Minnie and also Pluto, coming in at $20. And then we have 10778 Mickey, Minnie and Goofy's Fairground Fun with 184 pieces, three minifigures for $30. 10780 Mickey and Friends Castle's Defenders with 215 pieces, four minifigures, that one coming in at $50. And we also have a brand new Frozen set, that one being a 4+ set, and also a brand new Disney Cinderella's Castle. And we also have a Harry Potter polybag being 30435 Build Your Own Hogwarts Castle. I'm sure this one will be gift with purchase at some point during the year. And then another one I'm really excited about is the brand new LEGO Harry Potter Brickheadz pack, being the Professors of Hogwarts, giving us four brand new exclusive Brickheadz, coming in at $40 or £40. This one launching on June 1st. Definitely a day one buy for me. And then we actually look at LEGO Friends. I'm not going to go into detail on every set because there are some good ones. You can see there's a brand new giraffe included in a safari set. There's a great style of building included in one of the bigger sets. There's also like a recycling truck which you could use in your LEGO city, and even a brand new sailboat which doesn't look too bad. And then you've also got a roller disco. All of these could easily be included in LEGO cities if you have them. LEGO dots I've just touched on briefly. There's the usual kind of pencil cases, holders for your scissors or whatever. There's some brand new ice cream photo frames which kind of look cool. Also a panda box, and then also just some more of the crafty kind of style we get with LEGO dots. But some good sets are definitely coming up for fans of those. And then we have images of the one of the two LEGO Marvel sets for June, this one being 76217 Baby Groot with 476 pieces, coming in at $50. This one, a great build style. Definitely one I'll be picking up, and it's just such a good display model. Then we can move on to LEGO Minecraft with 21184 The Bakery with 154 pieces, with characters such as a baker, a snow villager, a goat and a creeper. That one being $20. And then you have 21185 The Nether Bastion with 300 pieces, with characters such as a piglin brute, a never slime, a strider. That one coming in at $30. Then we have 21186, the ice castle with 499 pieces, with characters such as a yeti, a zombie, and a skeleton. That one being $50. And we have the retailer exclusive 21187 with the barn with 800 pieces, coming in at $90. And then we have an absolutely incredible set. We have 21188, the llama village with 1,252 pieces, with pillagers, a villager, llama, and baby sheep with $120. It's just a giant brick built llama which you can open up. What do you not love about that? And we actually have an interesting set, this one being a Mythica set, which is a Legoland exclusive set. It's an interesting set with some mythical animal builds included as kind of builds which you can add on to this one. That one I think will be available from June for around about $40, I'd say. And we move on to Lego Creator 3-in-1. We have 31130, the Sunken Treasure Mission, this one being a 3-in-1 set, coming in at $35. If you're just submarine, also an octopus, not a bad set at all. And then we have 31131, the Downtown Noodle Shop, with 569 pieces, this one with two minifigures for $45. And with that one also being a 3-in-1, there are alternate models to build with that one, all which look pretty decent. And we also have a Creator polybag, this one being a little winter train. That one will be a nice little build as a gift with purchase. And we also have these classic cards as part of LEGO's 90th anniversary sets. And then we add on the LEGO Creator Viking ship, which has previously been announced. That concludes the Creator wave. So that is a lot of things, but what is still left to be revealed? Well, we still haven't seen images of the pyramid. That one launches on June 1st. Also 31206, the Museum of Modern Art, being the other LEGO art set. Also 76216, the Iron Man Workshop, that one coming in at $90. And then also 80037, the Dragon of the East for $80. That one being the final Monkey Kid set left to reveal. But from what we've got, an incredible summer wave once again. Day one buys for me will be the Heavenly Realms incredible set. Also the Brick Brickheadz, as I'm a Brickhead collector. I buy every single one, and probably that bathtub one, because who doesn't love that one? But comment down below, which ones are you excited for, which ones are you not? So much to cover today. Please like the video, subscribe, and turn notifications for more Lego videos and Lego news videos. Do you watch any of your videos on screen now? Remember guys, keep clicking and bricking. I'll see you all later guys. Bye bye.